हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स। इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी स्टार्ट द चैप्टर सर्कल एंड इन दैट क्लास वी डिस्कस ऑल द कॉन्सेप्ट रिलेटेड टू सर्कल। ओके, इन प्रीवियस क्लास वी डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट इज द रेडियस ऑफ द सर्कल, वी डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट इज the diameter of the circle, we discuss about what is the chord of the circle, we discuss about segment, we discuss about sector, we discuss about central angle. Okay, there are so many things we discuss about in previous class. Today we are going to discuss some theorem of that chapters. Okay, first we are going to discuss the theorem. First we discuss about the congruent arcs. What are congruent arcs? What is the concept of that? So yesterday I discussed about congruent circles. Two circles are said to be congruent to each other if their radii will be same, or one circle two circles are superposed to each other, then it is said to be congruent because of two shape of solid are said to be congruent if and only if their shape and size are same. Okay, now first we discuss about the congruent arcs. Let's see, first we discuss about the congruent arc. What is congruent arcs? Let's see, suppose that two circles here and that is centered there, here arc AB. Okay, and this is one another triangle, this is their center O dash and arc CD. We take arc as CD. Okay, here two arc, here one arc is AB, that is what is arc? In previous class we discussed about arc na, a continuous piece of a circle is known as arc. Okay, right, so here AB and CD are two arcs. When these arcs are said to be congruent arcs? Let's see, two arcs are said to be congruent to each other if and only if the angle subtended by arc at the center of the circle is same. When the degree measured by an arc at the center of the circle, degree measure of an arc is same, then it is said to be congruent arc. That is, if this is theta, means degree measure of an arc is equal to theta, and this is also equal to theta, degree measure of an arc CD, or arc CD is equal to theta. If theta will be same, theta is what? Your central angle, na? This is your central angle. If the central angle will be same, then we can say that the arc is congruent to each other. Okay? So, dear students, this is the concept of congruent arcs. So we can say that two arcs are said to be congruent if and only if the degree measured by that will be same. If the degree measured by an arc is same, then they are said to be congruent to each other. That is, degree measure can arc AB congruent to degree measure of an arc CD. If and only if degree measure arc AB is equal to degree measure of an arc CD, then the arc is said to be congruent, that is congruent to each other. Okay, so this is the condition for congruent arcs. If they have the same degree measure, then we can say that these are congruent to each other. Now, dear student, we are going to discuss some important theorem of your NCERT exercise in that chapters. Let's see. Let's see some result on congruent arcs and chords. Okay, let's see a theorem. Very important theorem of your NCERT exercise. Let's see the theorem. if two arcs of a circle are congruent, if two arc of a circle, two arcs of a circle are congruent, are congruent, then corresponding chords are equal. Then you have to show that then corresponding chords are equal. Chords are equal. This is your theorem. Here your theorem is if two arcs of a circle are congruent, then corresponding chords are equal. Okay. Let's see. First of all, we draw two circles. Let's see. Okay. Here that center O' is, and let its center is O and O' dash. And here let's see, AB and CD be their arcs, okay, and their corresponding chords are AB and CD, okay. Their corresponding chords are AB and CD, and we join OA and OB, and here OC and OD, okay. Now, first of all, we write given. Two arcs of a circle are congruent. This is given that. Okay? Here two circles C with center O and radius R. And another circle C dash with center O dash and radius R. Radius will be same, okay. And here two circles C with center O and radius R, and another circle C dash with center O dash and radius R, and up the let here two circles and their arc will be and the arc AB congruent to our CD. It is clear that na? It is given that because of according to question, two arcs of a circle are congruent to each other. So here, first of all, we draw two corresponding circles having the same radii with center O and O dash, and here AB and CD is to be arc, and these arc are what? Congruent. So we have arc AB congruent to arc CD. This is given that na? Okay, now we have to show that what? We show that the corresponding chords are equal. We have to show that the corresponding chords as AB is equal to CD. What is chord? Yesterday I discussed about chord, because chord is a if the line joining any two points on the circle is known as chord, and we have to show that chord AB is equal to chord CD. Let's see. Now given, and now we write two proof. What we prove? Corresponding chords are equal. That is chord AB is equal to chord CD. We have to show that chord AB is equal to chord CD. This is, we prove that. Okay, now construction. What we do? Draw two circles. We join OA, OB, O'C and OD. Okay, we have to do some construction here. So we write as construction. What I do? Join what? OA, OB, O'C and OD, O'D. Okay, now let's prove it. Now we take triangle AOB and COD. Okay, now in triangles in triangles AOB and CO dash D. We have what? OA is equal to O dash C. Let's see. OA is equal to O dash C because of each equal to R, radius R. Each equal to R, na? Because of here OA and O dash C are radius and radius is R. Same in that theorem. So OA is equal to O dash C, each equal to R. Same as angle AOB is equal to angle ACO dash D. Why? Because of two R here, two R congruent to each other. Na? And recently, just I discussed about that when two R congruent to each other, they have the same degree measure. Mean their central angle form the central angle will be same. So here angle AOB is equal to the angle CO dash D. Because of since when why the arc AB congruent to arc CD. So therefore degree measure of an arc AB is same as degree measure of an arc CD. Because of this right in that way, okay, this angle central angle is same because of here two arcs AB and CD are congruent to each other. So if we just we discussed about that, if two arcs are said to be congruent if and only if their degree measure is same. So degree measure of arc AB is equal to the degree measure of an arc CD. So here we write as angle AOB is equal to angle CO dash D. Okay, and now OB is equal to O dash D. OB is equal to O dash D. It is also equal to each equal to R. Each equal to R. Now let's see, dear student, by which congruence criterion of triangle? By side angle side congruence criterion, these triangles are congruent to each other by using which criterion of congruence? Side angle side. So thus by SAS criterion we have what? Triangle AOB congruence to triangle CO dash D. So by CPCT, what? AB is equal to CD. CPCT AB is equal to CD. Hence proved our result. So dear student, this is one of the most important theorem of your NCERT exercise, and these results always point to remember. If two arcs are congruent to each other, then their corresponding chords are always equal. So let's see once more time. In proving that theorem, first of all we draw two circles having radius O and O dash and radius equal to R, which are given, and we take two arcs as AB and CD and join OA, OB, O dash C and O dash D. Now we are going to prove the corresponding or in that theorem we have to show that AB is equal to CD. First, in we take triangle AOB and triangle CO dash D, and in that triangle first of all we prove it congruence. So for congruence we have OA is equal to O dash C because of each equal to R, same as OB is equal to O dash D, each equal to R. And according to theorem we have R AB congruent to R CD. Then just I discussed about that when two are congruent to each other, then their degree measure is to be same. So that angle means correspond that the central angle will be same. So angle AOB is equal to angle C O dash D, and OB is equal to O dash D, and OA is equal to O dash C, each equal to R. So by side angle side congruence of criterion of congruence, we have triangle AOB congruence to triangle CO dash D. So we write as AOB congruence to triangle CO dash D. So by CPCD means corresponding part of congruent triangles will be same, which that type of criterion I also discussed in that chapter triangles and quadrilateral. So by SS criterion, that is side angle side criterion, we have AB is equal to CD, hence proved. So dear students, first you practice all the theorems and then you can solve another theorem of your NCERT exercise easily. Now dear student, we take some other important theorem of your NCERT exercise. Okay, let's see. Now, this is very important theorem of your NCERT exercise. Let's see next theorem. The perpendicular from the center of the circle a circle to a chord bisects the chord. This is very, very important theorem of your NCERT exercise, and there are so many questions based on that theorem. Okay, now let's see. First of all, we draw a circle. Okay, let's see. First of all, we draw a circle with center O and radius R. Okay, and having P, take a point PQ and we draw as PQ, that is a chord. And here we, the according to theorem, the perpendicular from the center of a circle to a chord. So now we draw perpendicular on the chord, that is this, and we join OP and OQ. And we here, let's see, first of all we write given here a circle C with center O and radius R, okay, in which PQ as a chord, and we take PQ R at a point on its perpendicular, okay, and OR perpendicular to what? PQ. This is given in your theorem. Because of here, your according theorem, the perpendicular from the center of a circle to a chord bisects the chord. So first of all, we draw a circle C with center O and radius R. Okay, here each equal to R, OP and OQ also each equal to R, and in which PQ as a chord and OR perpendicular to PQ. Okay, now we have to prove that. To prove what, we prove bisect the chord as PR is equal to RQ. We prove that what? Bisects the chord, na? Yes, means RP is equal to RQ. We have to show that RP is equal to RQ, and we have to do some construction. we have to do some construction in that figure. Let's see. Join OP and OP, OP, OR and OQ. Okay, now we write as proof. Let's see. Now let's see. We take in triangle PRO and QRO. Here two triangle are subtended, na here. Now let's see. Now in triangle RPO and triangle RQO. Okay. In triangle RPO and triangle RQO. Let's see. OP is equal to OR. Here na? Here OP is equal to OR. Here OP is equal to OQ na? Yes. OP is equal to OQ. Why? Because of H equal to R. H equal to R. Okay. And what? Angle ORP is equal to angle ORQ. Because of H equal to 90 degree, right? OP is equal to OQ and angle ORP is equal to angle ORQ because H equal to 90 because of they are perpendicular to RQ and OR is common. OR is equal to OR. This is common. So by right hypotenuse side, RHS criterion of congruence, RHS criterion. So by RHS criterion we have triangle RPO, triangle RPO congruence to triangle RQO, RQO. Okay, thus by CPCT, what we have? CPCT means what? Corresponding part of congruent triangles. So by CPCT, RP is equal to RQ. RP is equal to hence proof. So let's see. So let's see, dear students, we have to prove RP is equal to RQ. So we can say that the perpendicular from the center of a circle to the chord bisects the chord means it divides the chord in two equal part as RP is equal to RQ, which we proved here. Okay, so R is the midpoint of PQ. So in this way we prove that theorem. Let's see once more time. First of all, we draw a circle with center O and radius R, and here we take P as Q are two points on the circle and join PQ as chord, and according to theorem we draw perpendicular from the center of the circle to the chord, okay, and join OP and OQ. Now we have to show that OR bisects the chord PQ as RP is equal to RQ. Now we take two triangle, that is RPO and RQO, and in that triangle, first of all, we write OP is equal to OQ, each equal to R, and angle ORP is equal to angle ORQ, each equal to 90, and OR as common. So, by right hypotenuse side criterion of congruence, we have triangle RPO congruent to triangle RQO. Okay, so thus by CPCD means that corresponding part of congruent triangles by CPCT, RP is equal to RQ, hence proved. So dear students, today we discuss two very important theorem of your NCERT exercise. So please do more and more practices on that type of theorems and solve some questions based on that theorem. Now we take a small questions some questions of circle based on that theorem. Let's see. We take some question. The radius of the circle is 13 centimeters. Your question is, the radius of a circle is 13 centimeters and the length of one of its chord and the length of one of this chord is 10 centimeters. Find the distance of the chord from the center. Find the distance of the chord from the center. This is your question here, okay? Let's see. So here your question is, the radius of the circle is 13 centimeters and the length of one of its chord is 10 centimeters. So first of all, let's solve it. First, we draw a circle with center O and take ABB a chord and join OA and OB. And according to question, radius of the circle is 13 centimeters, so OA and OB each equal to 13 centimeters and the length of one of its chord is 10 centimeters. Here first of all we write given AB is equal to length of chord AB is equal to what? 10 centimeters. And OA is equal to OB, this is radius of the circle, which is equal to 13 centimeter. And what we find? We find the distance of the chord from the center. Okay, now we draw that, and we know that these are perpendicular to the chord. We know that just according to theorem, if we draw perpendicular from the center to the chord, bisect the chord. So from figure we have, let that point be L. We have AL is equal to what? AB by 2, because of, we know that by theorem. This is by theorem. The perpendicular drawn from the center of the circle to the chord, that is bisects the chord, that is AL is equal to half of AB. So here the distance AL is what? AB by 2. AB is what? 10. 10 by 2 as 5 centimeter. So that distance is what? 5 centimeter. And we find the distance OL. And we find what? Distance OL. OL, okay? We find the distance of the chord from the center, na? So we find distance OL. Now using Pythagoras theorem in right angle triangle OLK. Okay? Now, in triangle OLA, what? Pythagoras theorem what? OA square is equal to AL square plus OL square. So OL square is equal to what? OA square minus AL square. So OA is what? 13 square minus AL is what? 5 as 5 square. So we have OL square is equal to 169 minus 25 as 144. So the distance OL is what? Under 144 as 12 centimeter. This is your answer. So dear students, the distance of the chord from the center is what? 12 centimeter. Okay? So dear student, in this way you can solve all the questions of your NCERT exercise. Now in next class we discuss some another questions based on that theorem. Okay, thank you.